I ended up in psychology because I was a historian and I worked as a magician in order to pay for my studies. I went into academia a bit late and ended up in a parapsychology unit because they found it useful to have somebody with the kinds of skills that allow you to fake psychic phenomena. Well, the psychologists have been interested in magic for a very long time, over a century. And a few years ago, there were some people who thought that we could do something more systematic, and I expressed some scepticism about that. But I'm not sure what psychologists can learn from magic, to be honest. I think they can probably learn more than magicians can learn from the psychologists. Because I think magicians work in the real world and they learn what works and they do it. And they have a rate of success that psychologists would probably envy. There are things that psychologists do that's based upon very specific expertise, and that psychologists might be able to learn specific things about perhaps areas of perception, persuasion, attention direction, of course, change blindness and attentional blindness. These are the things that people have taken some interest in. And it may be that magical techniques can be used in experiments to allow things to happen that might be psychologically interesting, such as the choice blindness experiments recently, which had nothing to do with magic except that they used a switch. So I think there's a lot of ways in which magic and psychology can interact. I'm not at all convinced that a systematic science of magic is the way forward, but I do think that we can continue to talk to anyone who has interesting things to say, not just magicians, but comics and singers and anyone who actually deals with real people in the real world. As many people before us have said, psychology deals with humankind, it deals with people. We are, as Graham Richards would say, we're people studying people. And that means that the knowledge that we produce in some way reflects our assumptions and values, the assumptions and values of the time and place. And so often there are things that we take for granted that, if nothing else, we need to realize that these are assumptions that we are taking for granted. And these things drive the questions we ask, the objects that we study, the methods that we use, the reasons that we do so.